What's going on, everyone? Welcome, Rabid here, and today I'm going to be showing you guys how to mine Karlsen. So this is pretty much a fork of Kaspa, but they did change the algorithm a little bit to remain ASIC resistant. So this is full GPU mining mode. So here we can see it is a fork of Kaspa with ASIC resistance, and it's also supposed to have a bit of a slower emission schedule, so it's not going to be as fast every month like we do see with Kaspa. So the first thing we are going to need is obviously a wallet. So over here we can see the latest version is version 1.0, and that was released 2 weeks ago. The coin's been around for a few weeks, I guess, at this point. And we're going to have to download the Windows version. For this, you know, just like everything, it is a brand new coin, brand new wallet. We have no idea what's going on in the background. So do not put this on a PC that you're using as your workstation or something. So I am going to be utilizing my node box right here. So once you do get that downloaded, then make a folder or something so you have a place to extract it. All right, so once you got a folder here, you can see Karlsen wallet. I'm just going to double click on this and I want to extract all into that. So I'm just going to browse where I did make that folder, down in downloads below it, Karlsen wallet, select folder, and it should extract it all in here. So we're just going to wait for it to do its thing. Now this is Windows 11, so I'm a little rusty. I usually upgrade everything to Windows 10. Yes, you heard that right. Upgrade to Windows 10. But now you can see we have all the binaries and everything here in the applications. Does look like we need to start a bat file, so we have to make our own bat file here to tell it to run with a certain parameter. Now, if you jump into their Discord here, you can see the command that actually has to be run. So it's this UTXO index is what you have to put inside of that bat file so that it runs the application as well as this starting parameter. So I'm actually going to make two files here, but first I'm going to tell you kind of what's going on. So here, this is the what we're going to need at first, Karlsen. Now, if you've ever made your own XMR wallet or something, this is pretty much how it is, running your own node, but we got to do the bat files kind of from scratch here. But this is like running your Monero D. You know, this will be your daemon that you got to run right here, and this is going to be your wallet. So I'm going to set up a bat file to run both my daemon. So I got to start that first so you can download the blockchain and let it sync and see all the transactions. And this will have to be fully in sync before you actually do see your incoming mining payments. So if we click on Karlsen here and just quickly go to properties, just to kind of show you what things mean. This is the application. It is an EXE file. So I'm going to set up my first bat file here. So I'm just going to right click on the bottom and I'm going to go show more options. We're going to go to new, and then text document. So I'm just gonna name this to, I guess we're gonna go, what is this called? Karlsen. Karlsen node. I'm just gonna call it Karlsen node. You can call it Karlsen daemon, whatever you want. This is where the blockchain node is gonna be running from. So I'm just gonna end that off. Now we're gonna come into this. I'm gonna right click and we gotta edit this. So we're gonna come in and open with Notepad. Pretty simple process here. And now I'm just going to bring this down so I can see exactly how this is all spelt. So Karlsen. So we're going to go Karlsen.exe. And then we're going to go space. We got to go dash dash here. And this is that command prompt, UTXO index. So UTXO index. That is it. So now we're going to go to file save as. You can try and set it to a bat file within the file itself, but I let find save as works all the time. Now we got to put this to all files, and then we're just going to simply put bat at the end. So dot bat, and then it should save it here. So we're going to save that. We're going to close this out. And we should now see that this is a bat file, and we're going to open it up again just so that you can actually see everything that's in here. So we're going to open it. And you can see, okay, I guess we're going to run it now. So we're going to allow access and just do it. So now you can see that it's connecting to the bat file and it's running everything. It is now beginning to sync up that daemon and everything for your wallet. So now that we actually have the daemon syncing in the background, we got to get our wallet address that we need to mine to. So we're going to make a command prompt right here and navigate to where we did extract everything and made that folder. So just for examples here, we're going to go to directory that is in my downloads here. So cd space downloads, directory again, just to see where we're at. So now we can see Karlsen wallet. So we got to go to that directory. That's the folder that we did make. I'm just going to move this up so I can see what I'm typing here. So Karlsen wallet, hit space, and now directory, and now we can see where all those files are. So we actually have to run this Karlsen wallet right here, .exe, and then use the create command to create a wallet. So here we can see Karlsen wallet.exe, and then space, create. Hit that, and now it's going to ask for a password. So obviously, I'm not going to show you everything, my real one. I'm just going to hit enter for my first one, enter for my second one. It's saying the file already existed because I was playing around with some things and stuff. But here we can see, you know, notice that neither above is a secret key to your wallet. Use this command right here to dump the data. So I'm actually going to copy this first so it doesn't disappear. I'm not sure if it will or not, so I'm just going to copy that. You can right-click it or Control-C. Now I'm going to hit yes that I want a new wallet. Hit enter, and now I'm going to run that command by simply right-clicking again and hitting that. So now this operation will print your unencrypted keys on the screen, and anyone that sees this can steal it. So now you're going to steal my seed phrase and take all my crypto. I'm just kidding, but I'm just showing you for experimental video purposes. So yeah, I want to show, I want to proceed. Here we go, enter my password, enter. That was an easy one. Now we can see our mnemonic seed here is right here. So take this and then copy it, obviously. So we're gonna go like this, right click, it's copied. Make a new notepad or something if that's something you wanna do. Highly recommended not to leave your seed phrase on your computer, but hey, you know, maybe you do. So now that we got our seed phrase and everything, we're actually gonna get an address that we can mine to. And up here you can see Karlsen wallet, new address. So we gotta run this command right here by simply highlighting over it, if I can get it correct here. Do it again, bam, and copy this. Right click, and then we're gonna put that down here and hit enter. Now it should load up, and it's going to tell us, we have to start the daemon. Okay, so it looks like we actually got to start the daemon first. If you run into that issue, it gives you the command right here. So we're actually going to start the daemon. This will sync up your wallet to your actual daemon. So we're going to right click this now and then paste that in there. And now it is syncing the daemon. Now we're going to go up here and we're going to have to navigate to here again while this wallet is syncing and use this command. So I'm just going to come in and grab this address right here. So I'm going to grab this, I'm going to copy this, right click, and now I'm going to start a new command prompt. Now this is syncing. Remember, this is syncing to your daemon, which is in the background right here. This guy right there. Nope, not that one. This one. The first one we set up. So this is getting all synced up to the blockchain. Your wallet is then going to sync to this, and you won't be able to see any of your mined transactions till both are synced up with each other. And then you won't be able to send anything either until both are totally in sync. So keep that in mind as well. Okay, so in the new command prompt, I navigated to, like we did the previous time, exactly where our wallet is. You can see here's all our files. Now I'm going to run this command for that new address. Hit that, and now this is our mining address right here. So obviously you're going to copy this and save it wherever. And this is the address you're going to use for your miner. So I'm just going to hit this, right click, and now I want to close this one out. I'm going to close this out as well. And I want to make a new text document. I guess this one right here is already here. We're going to show more options, edit this, and I'm going to put my mining address into this. So now that we got our wallet address, now we got to figure out a miner. And it looks like as of the latest SRB miner, they did add this into it. So we're going to be using SRB miner here. Okay, so once you do get SRB miner downloaded and extracted, scroll down and you will see start mining Karlsen here. So we're going to right click on this, edit. This is obviously a Windows guide to start with. We'll look at HiveOS in a minute. So here's the parameters, algorithm, Karlsen hash, that is the changed algorithm from what Kaspa K heavy hash currently is, to maintain ASIC resistance and GPU mining for life. So wallet here, the wallet we have, we're just going to copy it in. I actually emailed it to myself, so I have our tester wallet that you guys all know right now, right here. So here's our Karlsen wallet. And now we got to set up our pool. So I'm just going to get rid of all of this stuff in the pool, and we're going to run on over to Hero Miners, which is the sponsor of today's video, and just added this coin as well. So pretty simple process from this point. We're going to pick North American West USA. I'm in Western Canada. Choose the stratum that's closer for you. So I'm just going to highlight this, right click, copy that, come into our bat file here and paste that in like so. We're going to save this bat file like that. Now we do need a worker name, obviously, so I'm just going to come in here, put a period. I'm going to go Rabid WS for Rabid Workstation and save this again. I guess we didn't need to save it earlier, but now we have our worker name, our wallet address, the pool we're using. We got our algorithm. Everything is preset in here already. All ready to go. Now we got to start our miner. Okay, so I actually didn't set any overclock settings at all. We're just going to see what things are looking like. And in the future, depending on how this coin does, we're going to have to start tweaking a bunch of GPUs to see where we can get our best performances. So now we're just going to double click that bat file and see if we begin mining. So here we are. Loading up. It looks like GPU 0 and 1 is both loading up. So yeah, that's right. I also have integrated graphics on my 7950X. So that'll be interesting to see how well that may perform as well and if it's getting some hash rates. We can see GPU 0 did get an accepted share. I'm assuming that is the 3090. And then if GPU 1 sees anything, it's mining as well as integrated graphics. So right now we can see we are gaining some hash rate here. I'm just going to jump to the pool, put in my address, and see if we get all detected and what things, you know, begin to look like. So it looks like Rabid Workstation is now detected here. So that's awesome. We're starting to gain some hash rate at the pool. So we are up and mining now in Windows. So I waited for the first tick here and it looks like we're doing about 1.5 gigahash, 1,572 megahash on the 3090. And my integrated graphics is doing about 40 megahash as well. So that's pretty crazy. We are using quite a bit of power, so we're gonna need to do some tweaking. So yeah, we are up and running mining Karlsen in Windows. Let's jump on over to HiveOS. Okay guys, so here we are. First thing we got to do in HiveOS is add our wallet. So simply navigate over to the wallets here, hit add wallet, and then type our coin in the tracker. I really doubt it's here yet, so we're just going to go Karlsen like so, and I'm just going to put that in, put in our wallet address, and then name this video test hacked wallet, because you guys all know the seed phrase to this. So we're going to create that wallet. Next up, we're going to click on flight sheets, find our coin in the ticker here. So we're going to go Karlsen. It should be right there. Yep. Wallet, video test hacked. Pool is configuring the miner. And then we're going to choose SRB right there. And it is in HiveOS now. So if you need to update your rigs, just update them. And all the latest SRB features should be within the latest HiveOS features. And now we're going to name this test video Karl. And then I'm just going to go to set up our miner config. So we need to find our hash algorithm here. Pretty simple process, K-A-R, and it looks like Karlsen hash just popped right up for our wallet. We're going to go worker, followed by a period. And then for our worker name, we're going to hit that. And then I'm just going to cut this out. And I always put it beside the period here in this spot. Now, server pool and port, we're going to come back into hero miners here. Scroll on up and then copy your closest stratum. For me, this is USA West. Right click. Copy, go back into our flight sheet here, paste that in, and that's pretty much it. You know, again, I don't have any overclock settings or anything for this yet, so we're gonna have to do some testing, but that should be all you have to do for your flight sheet. Hit apply changes and create flight sheet. So I am in my test bench here, the RTX 3070, choose my worker, go to flight sheets. I'm gonna scroll down to the latest flight sheet we just had, which is Karlsen right here, and we're just simply gonna put that to the moon. All right, so here we are. It looks like I am pulling about 671 megahash. I do have some stock clock settings from when I was doing the Nuri XNA video there. So that's all we got running there. If we jump into the pool itself, we can see that the test bench is now detected as well. So there we go. Pretty simple process. The hardest part about this whole thing is setting up that wall. And I know a lot of you guys really did not like Ironfish due to that. And this one has a few more steps than even Ironfish. So it's going to be interesting to see how you guys react to this down in the comments section. I'm sure something new will emerge, like a GUI wallet, in the future. But for now, this is all you got. So the time is early. Will the coin do something? Very early spec mining phase, guys. Thank you for checking out this video. I will see you on the next one. Rabid out.